Good morning, everybody. Happy Thursday. It's August 10th, 2023. Great to be with all of you today. My name is Bob Lang, and I run explosiveoptions.net. And an amazing, wonderful chat room with some incredibly smart traders and people and so forth, and 250 people and counting in the chat room. Very happy and proud of what we've built here. It's a great location, and all of you will have an opportunity to try out the chat room starting next week. We have a promotion going on similar to what we had last year. It's called Deuces Wild. And what does that mean? Deuces Wild is it's going to be a promo for, you'll get a chance to try out all three services. Spread Trader, which has been a phenomenal year. It's up over 13% in 2023. The Explosive Options service, which is the one that I run, we've just had a phenomenal couple of months here, June and July. I think in July and August so far, we're up a ridiculous 22% in about 6 weeks' time. We're up nicely for the year. And then, of course, the third piece would be the chat room, which I just showed you is a great place to learn and to make some money as well too. So you'll have a chance to get on there for a couple weeks. That promo is going to start next week, and it'll run through the end of August. So let's talk about markets here for a little bit. As we know, the futures are up strong today. When I got up this morning, I saw that the futures were solid. Volatility was coming down. There was a spillover effect from overnight overseas trading. China was up, Japan was up, and I think Europe was up as well too. So a lot of that spilled over into our markets earlier this morning. And I think when the market is bid, and we see that overnight happening, it really doesn't matter what the news is going to be, right? And what we've noticed since last November, and I've talked about this several times, what we've noticed since last November, since that CPI number came out at the early part of November, which was the October CPI of 2022, we've seen that volatility sellers have gotten extremely active. What does that mean? Basically, they're taking high levels of volatility and starting to sell it after the news gets released. And that's normal action. Normal activity was what we see. When the response of the news is positive, then volatility starts coming down. And we did have a big pop in volatility earlier in the week. We did hit 18% on the VIX, and now it's coming down, right? It's down about to 15%. It's down, the VIX is down about 5% so far this morning. VIX futures are down about 5% as well too. So if that trend continues on today, then we're going to see markets continue to trend higher slowly and probably tick up towards the end of the session. That's just an observation from me, and it's something that I've been seeing for quite some time, and that's just a characteristic of the markets right now. All right, we're kind of in a bullish mode over here. We have these pullbacks that we've had for the past, you know, five, six sessions to start off August on a down note. We're down about 2.5% so far this month in the S&P 500. So this is something we have to follow the markets, right? We don't want to anticipate what's going to happen. Just if you wanted to anticipate yesterday, and one thing I mentioned in the chat room yesterday was, be prepared for any scenario. Be prepared for the markets to spike up. We didn't know if it was going to happen today, or spike down. We didn't know if that was going to happen today. But if you were prepared and you had some positioning on both sides of the market, you had some long puts, which I have, launching long put spreads, and I have some long calls and long call spreads, right? So I can now make an assessment based on the reaction and the response to the news and how the market is taking it. Obviously positively, and I can make some adjustments to the portfolio and not be on the wrong side of the trade, right? So we'll see what happens there. So let's take a look at the data here, right? First of all, I want to show you the Fed funds futures, which a little after 20 minutes after, still showing about a 10% chance of a rate hike in the September meeting, which comes out in about 6 weeks, 7 weeks, September 20th. We do have the Jackson Hole meeting coming up in about 2 weeks. And it's always interesting because Chair Powell is going to be, I think, keynote speaker at that meeting this year. And he always could come out with something jaw-dropping like he did last year. Markets got spanked last year after he came out and said that he saw a lot of rate hikes coming. And he wasn't wrong. He said a lot of rate hikes are going to be coming over the next year or so. And, accordingly, they're still in rate hiking mode. One of the Fed governors earlier this week, Mickey Bowman, she came out and said that we still are in a high inflation environment. We still could use more interest rate hikes. But then Patrick Harker from Philadelphia president came out and said, not so fast. Well, maybe we've reached the point where we can pause. So there's going to be some discussions at this next meeting in September. And of course, don't forget lots of data between now and the next meeting. We even have another CPI and PPI number. Of course, tomorrow morning is going to bring us the PPI number for July. And that number is hopefully going to be soft enough to rally markets again. Now, don't forget last month in July when we had the PPI number and the CPI number out in the markets, CPI number created a lot of interest and a lot of sparked a big rally. But the next day when the PPI number came out, didn't quite get that interest, and the markets kind of fizzled a little bit after that that report came out. So that's where we're at over here. I'm thinking that if you had to pinpoint when the next rate hike is going to happen, I think it's here. I think it's November. I don't think it's going to be September. I know there's a 10% chance. I think it's going to be November, and I think they want to slide into December, into the end of the year, and say, well, you know what? Look, we're going to pause here now, unless the inflation numbers start to tick up over the next couple of months. If we see that inflation number in August, which of course Cleveland Fed is looking for a very hot number coming out in August. I think they're looking for an annualized number of about 7%. Now, of course, this morning they were wrong. They were looking for an annualized number of about 4.8%. And it came in at half that much, 2.4. So, again, these are just guesses based on some model inputs that the Cleveland Fed is doing. Everybody else has their own models, and some are right and some are wrong. These guys were wrong this time around. Last month they were right. So the data here. So let's take a look at the data from the CPI today, and we can see that basically most of it is in line to slightly better. On the annualized number, we saw 4.7 on the core. Annualized, we expected at 4.8, came in at 4.8 last month. So that was a little bit better. The headline number also slightly better for the year over year, 3.2 versus 3.3. And the month over month CPI, also the core, came in line with what expectations were, 0.2, which is basically where we were last month. So we're cruising along at a level of 2.4% inflation for the past couple of months. And if that continues, markets are going to be happy about it. And the Fed, while it's not the 2% reading that they're looking for, it's close to that. And, you just get a couple of months where we come in at 0.1 or possibly a zero, that's going to skew the inflation numbers down. And the Fed is going to be more likely to pause and then possibly cut rates a little bit earlier. That would come maybe sometime in 2024. Again, it all depends if the data is printing out properly. All right. Initial jobless claims were slightly higher from last week, from 227 to 248. Tells us what? Tells us maybe the job market is softening a little bit. We do have another jobs report coming out right before Labor Day weekend. That'll be on September 1st. That's a Friday. Right in front of Labor Day weekend. It's kind of funny that in front of Labor Day weekend, we often see a good positive jobs report coming out. I'm not sure if it's going to happen again. Last week, of course, we had the jobs report number for July, and it came out pretty strong, pretty good. And the markets did rally a little bit, but then came back down right after that report was released. Later on today, we'll have that Philadelphia president, Patrick Harker, speaking, and that's a little after the close today, about 4:15 p.m. A couple of charts I want to share with you. This is one that I showed you a couple of days ago, and again, this is, you know, becoming a little worrisome here. And obviously, I know the markets are up today. This action is not going to get corrected in one day. But this chart shows you a cluster of new lows swamping new highs here. And this is, again, this should be worrisome for all of us here. If the NASDAQ, this is the NAHL, the NASDAQ is printing more new lows than new highs. That's not good breath. And it, of course, you know, when you have clusters like that, like we had back in earlier in the year, and then, of course, in 2021, lots and lots of clusters of this. We hardly had any prints above zero. We had lots of clusters of negative numbers here where the new lows were far outpacing the new highs. When that happens, we see markets starting to crater. NASDAQ, of course, for its part, up 38% in 2023. Pretty strong year. S&P 500 about 16.8%. Trailing the other two indices are the Russell 2000 up about 9%, and then the Dow Industrials, which had a nice winning streak back in July, only up about 6% in 2023. I want to share with you a couple of charts that I'm looking at today. China names are strong off the print of Alibaba this morning. That's a name that we got into yesterday. I added some of that. I can show it to you as well. I'd like to share that with you. You can see here, this is from the chat room. And again, you know what? We have this Deuces Wild promo coming up next week. This is the stuff you'd be able to see from the chat room. You can see yesterday I added some September Alibaba 95 calls at 590. That was about an hour or so before the close. And then a couple minutes later, added some September 100 calls. So I like to spread my risk around to different strikes. Some a little bit riskier than the others. Obviously, the 100 call September was a little bit riskier than the 95. But still, that's where I put my money, and it looks like it might get a good payoff today. So there's some other names in China that look pretty strong, and this is the one that I like right here, PDD Holdings. We had a nice little move up here into the 90s. We rode some of this move up here and took it off when it pulled back. Now it's pulled back to this 20-day moving average, which is this dotted line over here, and it held it nicely on Tuesday and yesterday. And I think this is one that's got some legs and probably get back to the old highs, call it about 106 to 108 on the old highs. So that would be a really nice move if we can get some legs up there. Earnings out in a couple of weeks, I believe on the 25th of August. A couple of the names that I have in mind here also, we were looking at this one this morning with CrowdStrike. And again, this is a stock that spiked up really nicely at the beginning of August, and it's just come down every single day since. Now it's nearly testing this 100-day moving average, which is the gold line here. And this is probably an area where you want to get interested in checking this one out, because it's come down about 15% off of this high. Now, I've noticed in the past with this particular stock that it has a nice run-up in front of earnings, but you probably want to exit it before earnings, or just have a very, very small piece of it on. So I've noticed back in May when it had this big, huge run, but right before earnings, and it came back down and fell backwards. Early part of March as well too, it had a nice run up, and then it fell back on after the when the earnings came out on March 4th. I think this has got the potential to do the same thing. They had really good earnings last quarter. And again, its stock just ran up a little bit too much in front of earnings. So this stock has will release their numbers on August 29th. So you've got about 2.5-3 weeks roughly to stay with this name and see if they get some big institutional money coming back in off of this steep correction here. See if this 100-day moving average holds. If it doesn't hold, and if it breaks this 100-day moving average and makes a run towards 200, we're out. We'll dump it. We're out of the stock. So at least we know, we can identify levels where the stock is no good, right? So that's CrowdStrike. And then also, I had my eye on Microsoft here. I don't know why. I was watching that one yesterday. And again, here's another stock, much like CrowdStrike, is making a run towards this 100-day moving average. May not quite get there today because the stock's going to be up a bit this morning. But the 100-day moving average, you can see, comes in at around 315, 316. It's about $6, closed yesterday, about $6 above there. It's had a really nice correction over here, a nice pullback from the recent highs, down about 10% roughly from those highs from the middle of July. And then it had that earnings boom on the to the downside, and it's made been making lower highs, lower lows. Got some support down here, right where that 100-day moving average is, called about 315 to 317. So if it does come back there, that might be an area you want to pull the trigger and start backing up the truck and adding some stock, or perhaps maybe going out to October or so, maybe buying some at the money calls. And then the last one I'm looking at here is YETI, which came out with earnings this morning, which were real strong. This is a retailer. They make those thermoses and coolers and so forth. This is a stock that I've had my eye on for a long, long time. I do like the name and do like the products. The stock trades very erratically. There's not a whole lot of stock out there issued here. So the stock does trade with a lot of, it'll upset your stomach if you're in this name for a long period of time. You can see the big moves the stock makes to the upside and all the way down to the downside, from 45 all the way down to 35 and right back to 42. So you got to hang on. You got to have an iron stomach for this one. But this stock, if it gets above that 20-day moving average, let's call it 41 and change, might get up there this morning. And it confirms it tomorrow or Monday, might be a good one to ride back up towards that $45 level. So that's it for stocks here. So I wish you guys all a great trading day. Take it slow, keep some protection on, raise some cash as you should, and just wait for the next move. Don't forget, tomorrow is the PPI number. So again, you're going to see some volatility coming in once again to the markets in anticipation of that, and they might let the air out tomorrow and Friday post PPI number. So anyway, have a great day, everyone, and hopefully we'll get a chance to see all of you in the chat room when the Deuces Wild promo starts next week. And look forward to seeing with all you guys then. And next Daily Bites coming up on Monday. Next Monday is the 14th of August. And I'll see you guys all. See you guys all next week. And if you're in the chat room, I'll see you there. Have a great day, everyone. Take care, and I'll talk to you soon. Thank you.